Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to write the expression of the tangential acceleration vector. Write the characteristics of the tangential acceleration vector. Write the expression of the normal acceleration vector. Write the characteristics of the normal acceleration vector. Calculate the magnitude of the acceleration vector. Distinguish between uniform motion and uniform circular motion. Distinguish between rectilinear motion and uniform rectilinear motion.
In the previous video, we defined that the acceleration vector occurs due to the change in the velocity vector. Now, let's study the tangential acceleration. Watch this animation. Consider a car moving on a straight path. Now, the animation is in slow motion. As you see, the speed of the car changes with time. The tangential acceleration occurs due to the change in the speed of the moving object.
In the previous video, we explained the x and the y components of the acceleration vector. Now we are going to explain the tangential and the normal components of the acceleration. Let's start with the tangential component vector of the acceleration. At equals at times ut, which is equal to v prime times ut. But what do we mean by at, ut, and v prime? Consider a particle moving on a curved path. The green vector is the tangential component vector of the acceleration. It is tangential to the trajectory at any instant. Now I will repeat the animation to show you ut. Ut is a unit vector in the tangential direction of the trajectory, and it is in the direction of motion at any instant. Let's move to v prime. V prime is the derivative of the speed. At is simply the value of the tangential acceleration vector. Now, remember that in uniform motion, the speed is constant. If the speed is constant, then its derivative with respect to time is zero. Therefore, at equals zero. What do we conclude? We conclude that the tangential component of the acceleration exists only when the speed varies.
The tangential acceleration is a vector quantity, so it has four characteristics at a point M. Origin, the point M itself. Line of action, it is tangent to the trajectory at point M. Now, what's about the direction? We have two cases. First case, it is along the direction of the motion, or the same as V in accelerated motion as in figure A. Look at figure A, AT and V have the same direction in accelerated motion or when V increases with time. In the second case, the direction of AT is opposite to the direction of motion in decelerated motion. Look at figure B. AT and V have opposite directions in decelerated motion or when V decreases with time. Finally, its magnitude is given by the derivative or the magnitude of the derivative of the speed with respect to time, and the magnitude is always positive.
Let's move to the normal acceleration. Consider a particle moving on a circular path. Observe the velocity vector of the particle. The direction of the velocity changes with time. The normal acceleration occurs due to the change in the direction of the velocity of the moving object.
Let's study the normal acceleration vector. The normal component vector of the acceleration vector A is called the normal acceleration, or the radial acceleration, or the centripetal acceleration. This acceleration is denoted by An. The expression of An is given by An un, which is equal to v squared over r times un. An is the magnitude of the acceleration vector An, which is equal to v squared over r, where v is the speed, and r will be studied later on this video. Now watch this animation. It shows the acceleration vector A and its normal component An. As you see, an always normal to the trajectory at each point, and it is along the principal normal direction to the curve. Now we observe un. Un is a unit vector along the principal normal direction to the curve. As you see, an is directed along the direction of un.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, what do we mean by r? R is the radius of curvature of the trajectory at any point. Consider the curved path in the figure. We draw three oscillating circles on the path. The oscillating circle at a point is the best circular approximation to the curve at this point. The curvature of the circle is exactly the same as the curvature of the curve. Now consider point A. Look at the oscillating circle. This is the radius of curvature at point A. Similarly, this is the radius of curvature at point B. Look at point C. We didn't draw the whole oscillating circle at point C because it is very large. Look at the radius of curvature at point C. The dotted line means that this radius of curvature is very large. Another important remark. Look at AT and AN. AT is tangential to the trajectory at any point, and AN is directed towards the center of curvature at any point. Therefore, the acceleration factor is always directed towards the interior of the curve at any point.
Consider a particle moving on a curved path. This animation shows the radius of curvature r and the oscillating circle at each position. It shows that r and the center of this circle change with time, and it also shows that the radius of curvature increases as the curve gets flatter.
Now, we want to prove that an exists only if the described path is curved. In rectilinear motion, r tends to infinity. Look at this expression. If r tends to infinity, then an equals zero. Therefore, an exists only in curvilinear motion. Now let's move to the characteristics of the normal component vector of the acceleration at a point m. The origin is the point m. The line of action is along the principal normal to the trajectory at m, and the direction is towards the center of curvature of the trajectory at the point m, which means that the normal component vector is centripetal. The magnitude of the normal component vector is v squared over r, where v, as you know, is the speed and r is the radius of curvature at the considered point.
This animation shows the acceleration vector of a moving particle along a curved path. Now, the animation shows the tangential and the normal component of the acceleration vector A. So, A vector can be written as AT vector plus AN vector. Since AT and AN are perpendicular to each other, then the magnitude of the acceleration vector equals the square root of the magnitude of the tangential acceleration squared plus the magnitude of the normal acceleration squared.
Now, we want to distinguish between uniform motion and uniform circular motion. Here we have AT equals V prime, AN equals V squared over R, and the acceleration vector equals the tangential component plus the normal component vectors. Let's move to the uniform motion. You know that in uniform motion, the speed is constant. Therefore, AT equals zero. If AT equals zero, then the acceleration vector is equal to the normal component vector. Let's move to the uniform circular motion. It is a uniform motion, then A equals AN. But if the path is circular, then the radius is constant. If the radius of curvature is constant, then the acceleration vector has a constant magnitude, but a variable direction. This is because un is directed towards the center of curvature of the trajectory at any point, so it has a variable direction.
Now, let's distinguish between rectilinear motion and uniform rectilinear motion. We have at equals v prime, an equals v squared over r, and a vector equals at vector plus an vector. In rectilinear motion, the radius of curvature tends to infinity, or we have no change in the direction of the velocity, so the normal acceleration equals zero. So in rectilinear motion, the acceleration vector equals the tangential acceleration vector. This figure shows the trajectory of a moving particle along a straight line. At position A2, the acceleration vector A2 equals the tangential acceleration at this position. Now, in uniform rectilinear motion, we just proved that in rectilinear motion, A vector equals AT vector, but AT vector equals V prime UT. But in uniform motion, V is constant, so the time derivative of the speed equals zero. Therefore, in uniform rectilinear motion, the acceleration vector equals zero. This figure shows the trajectory and the positions of a moving particle M in uniform rectilinear motion. So, in this case, the acceleration vector of the moving object equals zero. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.